Yes, I know, another version of the plane to grow system. This is technically version 4. You saw my movie before about version 3, and you saw all my other movies about all the other versions. It's really more like version 10, but anyway, we're not going to quibble. It's kind of like a software company. Come up with all these versions and releases, and I think this one's probably going to be the most major change, and now I'm going to refine it down to things like organic nutrients, things like that, just trying out new things. And you can see it's plants looking pretty good, and the whole concept of this from the beginning was to use what I had, be able to use recyclable material, milk jugs and that sort of thing. But I was using styrofoam cups and plastic cups, and I kind of wanted to get away from that, so I made this little net bag out of drawer liner, and it's a type of plastic I think it'll probably recycle okay. I glued the edge and glued the seam with some Gorilla super glue and tied off the bottom with a tie wrap. As you saw before, now the black stuff, I know this looks like a kid's volcano project or something like that, but the black material is actually just ground weed fabric that I wrap around it to keep out the extraneous light. You can see the temperature is about 68-69 degrees. That's sort of on the low side for these tomatoes, but that's all right. When the house heats up, when I've got the heater going, it hits about 75 in here. We've got a heating pad down here. I've kept it on the whole time, so at least keeps it above 60 degrees. I think it's going to take a while to warm this thing up. Now, this plant's been growing about 30 days. It's taking its sweet time. Of course, it's January, and it's cold out. It's 20-something today. This time, the way I'm doing it was to keep the plant from jumping up and getting so tall so fast. And so I decided to keep it growing in the cup that you saw before until it got a lot taller. And I decided to keep it in the peat moss pellet. At first I was considering washing away the pellet and just putting the plant with its roots straight into the media. But I decided against that because the peat moss pellets, some people tell you don't use them with hydroponics, that they're no good, that they're too acid and this and that. I've not had any problems with them. They work fine on all my plants, and they give a good grip for the roots until they take hold in the media. And so I have no problem with that, and it's not soil. You know, if you want to get technical about it, say this isn't hydroponics, well, peat moss is not soil, okay? It's organic material, and you can see I've got the mixture that told you about before in the other movies. It's a mixture of perlite and the coconut husk that was chopped up, and that's all there is in there. There's no dirt, nothing else, and those roots should be reaching down into nutrient solution here pretty soon. I haven't looked at it recently, but it shouldn't take too long. That's a real basic setup. I'm doing this to make everything simple. Everything's recyclable. It's easy to find. You can modify this and use it other ways. You can use it in a bucket. Being discreet like this, individual plants, I've seen some setups where you have 3 or 4 plants in a bucket, or storage type container or something like that. Well, the problem with that to me is that if one of the plants gets a disease, if it becomes diseased, it's going to affect the other plants too. This just keeps them separate. And it just it finds a way to use up stuff that's going into the landfill. So that was part of this project, just to see if I could come up with something that was really simple that people around the world could use. And at some places where stuff isn't quite as available as we've got. We've got it good. We've got good electricity going, and we've got pumps and all kinds of things that the more complicated hydroponics would use, but this is something that could be done just about anywhere. I mean, you can do this anywhere in the world. You can do it in the tropics. You can do it in the desert. It's very water conserving. It does not take a lot of water, and you can probably recycle this stuff. You can probably strain out the organics and sterilize the water, what's left, and when you drain this, I would highly recommend that when you first start out doing this with this system, you fill and drain it several times over several weeks. I've been kind of bad about that, not doing that. I've been checking with my meter, checking the EC and the pH and everything, and so far so good. I mean, I think this is going to be a very healthy plant, and somewhere down the road when it finally gets some good root systems and starts thickening at the base of the stem there, I'll start using the Clean Green Formula X. We'll start talking about that chemistry and what it does for the plants. And like I said in my last video, it's not for sale. It's not something you can mix up ahead of time. It's just some common chemicals. When you mix them in the proper order at the proper time, they're really good for the plants as far as I can tell. But I'm still experimenting with that. I'm not going to really go anywhere with it until I'm absolutely sure it's not going to harm my plants. So I haven't been using it on this one yet. This is just a straight 111 mixture of the general hydroponics nutrients, the flora grow, I can't even remember the name of them right this minute, but it's 1 teaspoon per gallon of water on those, the general hydroponics chemicals. Now, in my previous videos, you can find a lot of information about them and how to mix them and how to use them. And in the past, I've been using a pretty strong solution, like 222 or 223, or, you know, I've tried all different kinds, and right now I'm going to let this grow on the 111, which is what I also use for foliar feeding. Of course, I'm not going to foliar feed this until it's robust and more mature, but I'm going to let it take a little extra time and just search for the nutrients and be able to not clog up the passages in the plant. I think part of my problem in the past, to some extent, was that there was probably a little too much salts in the solution, and then the passageways in the plant would get clogged a little bit. So it'd be getting water, but not all the nutrients were getting up to the leaves and stuff. So we'll see how that goes. Usually I have at least 10 plants going. This time I only have one. I don't have the greenhouse done. It's the middle of the winter. I don't have a lot of room here, as you can see. Now, I've had up to 20 plants sitting on this platform here, but, you know, family needs, job needs, some other things going on in my life, I've taken a pretty big step back from this for right now. But one plant at a time right now during winter gives me a chance to figure out some things. Now, as of yesterday, the bottoms of these leaves were very purple. You can see now today they're nice and green. And that generally shows a magnesium deficiency. Now, the way I'm doing versions 3 and 4 now, what I'm doing, being wickless, is it's forcing the plant roots to search for the nutrients in the moisture. Instead of having it wick up next to it and kind of babying it along, so to speak, these plants have to work a little bit harder. They have to go down deep into the media, which this media here is as deep as the jug, the gallon milk jug. So we're looking at about 8 inches, I guess. But it causes the plant to search and not grow up tall as quickly, which is good. My last plants got very spindly and tall. I mean, they were healthy and everything. They just got pretty tall, and so they didn't produce as much as they should have. You can see this one's a lot more robust, very pretty plant. Still growing a little bit fast on the height. I do believe the light has a lot to do with it. Like I said in previous videos, the reason why you don't want to have your plant grow too tall too quickly, that can create as many problems as a lot of other things going on with your plant, including diseases. But you have some plant tissues called xylem and phloem, and the xylem is tissue that allows nutrients and mostly fluid to move up to the leafy areas of the plant. It does not move down, only up. And then the phloem is a bidirectional tissue that allows fluids and nutrients to move up and down from the plant. And so if you get something that's going too thin and too fast, those things get kind of restricted. You have water molecules, which are pretty big, and then you have some nutrients, some of their molecules are very large, some aren't. So sometimes you'll have a situation where some of the nutrients will get up to the plant fine and others will get left down at the roots or not even get into the roots. And then you start having certain kinds of starvation issues with these plants. I've had that before with tomatoes, especially during a very hot summer. You would actually get a fair amount of moisture up into the plant, but no nutrients. And so it sucked down the jug of fluid very quickly. I had to fill these milk jugs once a day with nutrient solution, but none of the nutrients were actually getting up into the plant. So the plant was actually starving. So those are just two fancy words for tubes that go up and down the plant, help transport nutrients and fluids. And if the plant grows too fast and too skinny, like this one's on the verge of it, not quite there. This one's doing better than the other ones I've had in the past. And I'm not sure what to do to fix that exactly with this system. But that's, you don't want that. You want it to get thick before it gets tall. I still think it looks like a kid's volcano science project, but it does its purpose. It does what it's intended to do. You can see the plant is very robust, doing exceptionally well. It's about 3.5-4 inches away from the light. I've moved this light up as far as it'll go on the little bar that I made to hold it. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this plant at this point. You can see it's very robust, very green. I'm very pleased with it. I haven't used any formula, clean green formula X yet. This version 4 is working exceptionally well. No problems that I can see. And it's a very simple system now. I guess the biggest problem I've got at this point is where to put the plant. Normally by now the plant would have gone into the greenhouse along with about 15 or 20 other plants. Since I don't have a greenhouse to put anything in right now, it's the middle of winter and I'm still building that newest greenhouse, I'm going to have to figure out what to do with this plant. Now, this plant right now is about 35, 38 days old, so it's doing exceptionally well. It's growing very quickly. In fact, it might be at a point right now where it's starting to get a little bit leggy. It might be growing a little bit too tall too fast. But you can see the stem is quite thick. It's looking very good. So no real issues with it. I'm very pleased so far. Well, necessity is the mother of invention. You can see I had to take off the light bar and turn it vertically. You can see the PVC pipe bar that it was attached to. And this lets this little jelly bean hybrid tomato plant grow up taller past the bar. This is the only plant I'm growing right now. I'm just doing a few experiments with it. And I'm going to leave it indoors since I don't have the greenhouse yet. You can see the plant is very robust, very green, growing quite well. It's put on a lot of height in the last couple days. You can see my little invention here using coat hangers to try to stabilize the plant and let it have a place that it can hold on to and support some of the plant weight. I usually use a PVC pipe frame with some strings inside the greenhouse to stabilize my plants, but since this plant's going to stay indoors for its life, this is what I'm going to go ahead and do. I'm very pleased with this plant. I have done nothing else with the nutrients except continue to use the 1-1-1 mixture of the General Hydroponics nutrients. Sometime down the road, I may go ahead and start using my organic nutrients that I'm working on, and I'll let you know more about that.